While we beat Halo 1, 2, 3, ODST, and Reach to the best of our abilities without shooting, one thing we really wanted to know was, is it possible to complete the final level of Halo 3 without getting in a vehicle? Sure, you can complete the level without a Warthog, you can hop in a Ghost or use the Prowler or even a Mongoose to beat the final drive, but let's say hypothetically, Johnson's Warthog wasn't there. What would Master Chief and Arbiter do, and how far could they actually get if they were trying to make it through the final Warthog run from the level Halo in Halo 3? Well, today we're gonna take a look. We'll be honest, this one was definitely something we did not think we would get very far on. We thought from the very first moment you are supposed to be in a Warthog, we would pretty much fall off the map and that would be the end of this test. And this was actually intended to just be a small section of an upcoming video that we're still working on, but this kind of turned into its own behemoth of a quest that we wanted to take a look at. So starting things off on our very first run on foot, right away we noticed that the map starts to fall apart the second you walk on some of the main tiles that you typically drive on, meaning that making a run to the first platform that you typically get to when you start the run is actually pretty difficult as things just fall apart quickly. So instead, what we tried doing was hanging left at the beginning of the Warthog run and sticking as close to the rock walls as possible to avoid or delay the map from destroying all of the platforms as quickly as it typically would. Once we followed the pathway that wrapped around the cliff, getting all the way to the entrance of the very first tunnel, we kind of thought we were a little bit stuck here. We knew we would have to come up with some crazy or very difficult jumps if we were going to somehow pull this off and really test out how far we could fall before we would either hit a death barrier or hit an automatic kill barrier for falling for too long. After we played around with seeing how quickly we died in different scenarios, we realized that if we grenade jumped at the right time, we could actually land on the right ledge, which would let the other player die and respawn or make the grenade jump themselves to get onto the platform and see what other areas we could jump to. Once we made it to the higher section, we found it easiest to drop down and make sure we don't die in the process of that and walk all the way to the other side of the tunnel entrance. Then at the bottom of the ramp by the right side entrance, we jumped on each other's heads to elevate to another ramp that would eventually get us up to a higher section of this lower level tunnel. Now at this time, we're pretty much under the map, almost at the very bottom. The map will let you go without dying. So we had to pretty much find a way to get all the way back up onto the upper platforms if we were even gonna have a chance at getting through the tunnel, because there's no way to get through the tunnel if you're still under the map. Finally, after jumping on each other's heads, making some great buddy jumps and occasionally knocking the other person off the edge on accident or on purpose, one player has to make the ultimate leap of faith back onto the main platforms where the Warthogs are, while the other player has to be left behind and will have to use a grenade to respawn on his teammate. Now, one thing that we found was really interesting about going this pathway where we hugged the wall and jumped onto the cliff, rather than trying to memorize some sort of crazy pathway and running against the clock to run up to the tunnel the way that the Warthog normally would, is that by bypassing that first platform that we did when we hugged the wall and skipped it, we actually caused a skip in the level loading, which causes the tile sequence that normally causes the entire section to collapse, to actually not happen, meaning that we would be able to run through the entire tunnel without having to worry about the level collapsing in front of us, meaning that other than a pretty long hike from one end of the tunnel to the other, we actually had gotten pretty far, and we were feeling pretty good that we even made it past this first section in the Warthog run, because literally we didn't think we would get this far at all. However, as you approach the end of the tunnel, the platforms will begin to fall as soon as you are close enough, so we had to actually hurry pretty quickly to get onto the next platform and continue on. And at this point, the platforms moving forward throughout the rest of this run actually will fall apart based on how close we are, so there's no more skips we can actually use if we're gonna get through any more of this run. So once we made it onto the main platform, we noticed that the platform falls pretty quickly, and you only have a short amount of time to even drive through this platform before it falls off. So we ended up jumping over the main wall to try to buy as much time as we could to take on on the actual Warthog Run as where we are with this platform. There's no rock wall or easy permanent tiles to stand on that is easily accessible. We'd actually have to do a real run across everything like we were in Warthogs, except we're really slow on foot. Okay, so this part involved us actually doing a section of the Warthog Run on foot, and it was so difficult because ultimately we are just so much slower than Warthogs. We're constantly running and having platforms fall out and dephase from right below us where we just clip through the map, and we would often have the tiles literally falling just steps behind us as we were trying to make a run for it. And while we were at it, we had to try to memorize a route that would allow us to maybe make it to the far mountain that would give us some sort of platform to stand on where we can maybe catch our breath and not fall off the map and die. Naturally, since we wanted to get to the mountain on the left as quickly as possible, we tried to hang to the left the best we could, but we found that the platforms kept falling from right underneath us the second we got close enough to try to do some sort of jump making it to the cliffs. Finally, what we ended up finding was that if you hang right a little bit longer early on, maneuvering around a pillar, and you make a mad dash, literally hitting every single tile along the way perfectly, not messing up at all, and knowing the route, you can just barely make a jump for the cliff wall while everything else just completely falls apart right afterwards. But if you can make it this far, which we were just happy that we even got this far on the run, we were just a little over maybe the halfway point at this point, you can walk quite a ways on the rock walls. It's a pretty long hike as you have to wrap around the trail, or what used to be a trail. So while you're walking, you can kind of just enjoy your time, watch the destruction, feel all the earthquakes while you still have something that you can feel. So since the entire platform kind of falls apart in front of you, getting to that other platform section that would normally give you a checkpoint isn't really a valid option here. So if you thought the last sprint was hard, it only gets much worse from here. Pretty much as you approach the section after the platform, you have a mad sprint to the tunnel entrance, and this time there's no skip stopping the platforms from falling apart, which means the entire tunnel will fall out from underneath you. So essentially, you have to make your way inside of the tunnel before the map falls from beneath you, and you will constantly be having tiles just barely behind you when you're doing this run. We actually thought this part would be completely impossible just because of how far we had to go, but fortunately enough, if we just kept moving and didn't falter in any way at all, if you just do it at the right time, you can buy yourself just a few seconds before the entrance to the tunnel completely falls off. And from there, what we found out is we can jump to the left section of the tunnel, and there's this wall-like ramp, and you can actually stand on that, which will be your saving grace when you're in the tunnel, because essentially, while you're in the tunnel, the entire pathway will completely fall out from under you, and there's nowhere you can go. So since we found this ramp on the left-hand side, we're able to utilize this section to jump over each pillar and get to the end of the tunnel, letting us actually enter the final section of the Warthog Run, which was way further than we ever thought any player could get if they were not in a Warthog. And at this point, we had already spent hours on this level just trying to see what could work, what didn't work, and how we had to do the jumps to pull off some of this stuff. So as we were here, we had to jump on the ramps, constantly worrying about taking a jump the wrong way and sliding off the ramp, falling to your death. And this section is extremely strict with respawns, so if you die, your teammate is left completely alone and has to figure out what to do later. No more buddy jumps if you're dead. So we had to really make sure we were being careful and we did not die. However, after running through the entire tunnel, there was something so satisfying about standing there at the end of the tunnel and looking and actually seeing the Forward Unto Dawn in the distance. It was one of the coolest things we've experienced in just a challenge that we set on ourselves to do. This wasn't anything for an achievement, it was just something we wanted to see if it was possible that no one had really ever covered before. So just getting to the last section of the Warthog Run felt really awesome for us. We kind of stood at the end of the tunnel knowing that there really wasn't anywhere else we could go, as last time we were in a tunnel, we used the tunnel platforms to jump onto the tiles and keep going. But this time, by the time we got there, all of the platforms had already fallen off, meaning that we didn't have anything that we could use to jump back onto the tiles. What we didn't expect, however, was that if you fall the exact right way on the left-hand side, you can just barely drop down onto a ramp and not slide off the edge, triggering the level to instant kill you. And actually, from there, we already had the knowledge damage from when we entered the first tunnel that we were able to almost recreate a lot of the same jumps we did, jumping on each other's heads, doing random buddy jumps and double jumps off of each other to get up to a pretty high section of the little side ramp. Now, of course, this section doesn't let you respawn, so we had to do this several times just to see if we could even make a jump possible, because if one of us died, it was pretty much a wipe. Finally, though, after enough trial and error and a lot of precise jumping, we made a leap from the very top of the tunnel ridge all the way onto a section that had some rocks on the left-hand side. Now, this area is actually not necessarily an area you would ever go to when you're doing the regular Warthog run. It's kind of off to the side. You technically could jump over there with a Warthog itself, which we did a couple of times just to investigate what options we had for trying to make some sort of jump. But even then, we were inches closer to the forward onto Dawn, and it was just cool every time we did something that got us a couple steps closer to the end area. We really wanted to see how close we could get to the forward onto Dawn and see if we could even get to the point where we would at least be able to look inside the hangar or something. Unfortunately, despite us finally getting out of the tunnel, we were faced with the biggest kill to this run, and it was the fact that even though these platforms look very close, there was no way that we could get over to the platform. We tried every method that we knew. We tried just jumping, grenade jumping, jumping on each other's heads and jumping, and we even used a Warthog as a placeholder if it was like a third player that we would stack ourselves up on top of to see if a little more height could get us over there. And despite all of our jumps, there was nothing we could do to get back onto the main track that would actually get us maybe anywhere if it was even possible to begin with. And mind you, this was about 3 hours into us running through the Halo 3 level, and we were just proud of how far we had gotten. We took some time to explore around the area that we had never really seen before. You can actually climb up really high up the mountain and get a cool view around, and there's some other areas you can walk behind and jump on some things, but nothing that would actually bring us closer to the level. So despite everything, we were pretty sure that this was as far as you could humanly get without driving a vehicle. At this point in our run, we were absolutely exhausted, but despite everything, we still felt good about how far we got. This was really a lot further than we initially anticipated, and at that point, we called it quits, mostly being content with our outcome. But as I was brushing my teeth before I went to bed, I had an epiphany. And honestly, it was something that we really needed because it would give us one last thing we could try to see if maybe we could get further, or at least at the end of the day, we could say we exhausted everything that we could possibly think of. I remember a while back, we recorded a bunch of Easter eggs from Halo 3, and earlier in the level Halo, there's an Easter egg where it involves two players where one has a gravity hammer and you launch your teammate onto a platform where you can see a guy kind of dancing who worked at Bungie. So what if this time we played through the entire run, made sure that whoever is carrying the gravity hammer didn't die? Would it be possible that we could use this gravity hammer at the rocks to launch one of the players onto the main platform, giving us a chance to get even a little closer to the forward unto Dawn? Well, the next morning, we were going to give it another try, despite us kind of being tired of this level at this point. We still wanted to make sure that we had at least tried everything that we could possibly think of, and this was honestly the last thing, so it wouldn't be too much more work just to know and have it set in our mind that it would or would not be possible. So we started from the beginning of the level this time rather than the rally point, and went through the early section, killing the flood that drops with the gravity hammer, waited up on the cliff making sure we didn't die with the hammer, and sure enough, we brought the hammer with us all the way into the boss fight. Boom! Now all we had to do was kill 343 Guilty Spark and do the whole Warthog run again without a Warthog. But then we ran into another problem. Despite us utilizing the weapons and carrying the gravity hammer through the entire level, after you kill 343 Guilty Spark, the game triggers a cinematic that actually despawns the weapons that you're carrying and starts you off fresh again with an assault rifle. This was probably to prevent players from using a Spartan laser through the rest of the level, but because of this thing, it actually caused us to lose our gravity hammer. We thought we maybe had some sort of solution that would get us further along. If we played through the opening section again and we just didn't take the gravity hammer, would it still be there waiting for us when we got back? Since it only despawns your weapon when you're actually in the cutscene with Johnson. So then we restarted the level again, this time being sure not to pick up the gravity hammer, just killing the flood and moving on. We killed 343 Guilty Spark again, and then we ran back down the tower to the beginning area of the level just to find that the gravity hammer still wasn't there. It was weird because we saw other guns laying around, like fuel rod guns and spikers and whatnot, but for some reason the gravity hammer just wouldn't be there. And then what we finally concluded was that technically that specific gravity hammer isn't a weapon that spawns on the level at the beginning of the game. It actually spawns when you turn the corner and the flood first drops, which makes it possibly a temporary weapon rather than a permanent weapon that's always located in that spot. So then our next theory, and honestly the last thing we could possibly think of, is what if we started the level from the beginning, killed the flood, took the gravity hammer, kept the gravity hammer safe through the entire firefight, and then right before we went into the boss fight, we traded the weapon for a different weapon on the ground. We left it behind, trading it right after we killed the enemies and we were going to fight 343 Guilty Spark. We killed Spark another time, and finally, as we exited from the tunnel, the gravity hammer was actually there. We figured out a way to trick the game into allowing us to keep the gravity hammer for the next section of the run. Now, of course, we would have to run the entire thing again, making sure at all times that whoever was carrying the gravity hammer was always the one that never got left behind on any of the double jumps, and we had to make sure that the other player was the one to kill himself to get more grenades or drop grenades off for us to do the grenade jumps we had to do. Plus, we had to memorize routes, utilize checkpoints, and do everything we could to make sure we could carry the gravity hammer all the way back to the rocks towards the end of the level. But after all of that, when we finally made it back onto the platform, was it possible to get back into the main course of the Warthog Run before the level starts actually falling apart? And you are on kind of a tight time limit here as the map falls apart quickly. Well, we tried the gravity hammer jump. It actually worked. It pushed us back onto the platform and gave us enough room to make a sprint. And mind you, the tiles fall extremely quickly here, but we were able to make it back over to the cliff wall, which later let us do a skip around the left side, which got us in perfect view of the Forward Unto Dawn, which honestly, we never thought we would be able to actually get this far. At the section that we were standing at, this is where the final ramp would typically load, except since we went around, the ramp doesn't actually load and you just have nothing there. But you can actually see where the ramp normally would be. We knew we wouldn't be able to trigger the cutscene even though we tried doing some gravity hammer jumps just in case for some odd reason the cutscene actually would load without us being in a vehicle. And we also tried walking around the cliff the other way, wrapping all the way around the long way, but there's invisible barriers along the way that kind of knock you off. But like we said, even if we did get around that other way, the map would fall apart and not let you complete the level on foot. So ultimately, this is as far as we were able to get without using a warthog, and we felt completely 100% accomplished, as we pretty much like to say we completed the Warthog Run without a vehicle because we can see the ending of the level right there. Of course, it's not possible because the level itself won't let a player move any further. So while it's technically not possible, we figured out that this route should count to some extent, or in our heads, for whatever mental trophies we're trying to give ourselves for what we did. But honestly, I'm 100% content with how far we got, and 100% content with the fact that I never will have to do this again. It definitely took us a lot of trial and error, but ultimately it's really cool being able to experience a level in a way that the game developers never intended, and finding a way where something that literally was planned to be impossible was actually doable because we took the time into figuring it out. But ultimately, we'd love to hear your guys' feedback on this. Do you guys like it when we do these types of theories and these runs where we really look in depth on some random idea we have and see if it's possible? Because we have more ideas like this we want to work on. We have some stuff we're already working on that will be in upcoming videos. So let us know what you think in the comments down below. Be sure to subscribe with notifications on, whether you're already a viewer or you see us in recommended from time to time. If you want to see all of our videos we do where we put this much work into our stuff, if you're subscribed with notifications on, you'll see everything we put out. We're quite proud of a lot of the stuff that we've done. All right, guys, that's it for today, and we'll see you all next time with a brand new video.